Are you guys ready to meet the Swedish Mafia House? Oh, sorry. Are you guys ready to meet the Swedish White Arrow? And welcome back to our channel. I hope you all are doing well. In today's video, we have the Husqvarna Whitpillion 250 with us, and this one is a urban commuter, cafe racer styled. Special thanks to KTM Sai Service Wakadewadi for providing us this bike for this review. If you are looking for good deals in Pune, check out their dealership. And don't worry, because they are keeping your safety in mind and following all the guidelines issued by the government. And if you are new to our channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also go ahead and check out our Instagram, Facebook and Twitter pages and follow us there. We are present by the same name, that is Rev Explorers. Now let's begin with the review of the Whitpillion 250. Swatpillion and Whitpillion are just like twin sisters. Not exactly twin, because there are few changes. That one is a scrambler, this one is a cafe racer. So the handlebar has changed, the types of tire used in both of them are different, as well as you get a tank rack on the Swatpillion and not on the Whitpillion. So in the front you have the same LED headlight with LED DRL, and it is in round shape. With that are the LED turn indicators and upside down forks by WP. In the front, the Whitpillion gets a 110x70 section MRF revs tire, which is a radial tire mounted on a 17-inch black-coated alloy wheel. Along with that is a 320mm disc brake in the front, and this bike gets a dual-channel ABS setup. Just like the Swatpillion, the Whitpillion also gets this angular fuel tank design, and it is unique in its own nature. Sometimes it may be a head-turner. Just look out for it. In this bike, you get a 9.5-litre fuel tank, and hence I called it an urban commuter because of its small fuel tank capacity. The bike gives you an average fuel efficiency of somewhere around 32 kmpl, which is sufficient enough considering that it has a 249cc engine, which is liquid cooled DOHC and mated with a 6-speed gearbox. Now this liquid cooled engine delivers a maximum power of 30 PS at 9000 rpm and a peak torque of 24 Nm at 7500 rpm. Now the complete bike sits on a split steel trellis frame and weighs 153 kgs, which is 1 kg lesser than the Swatpillion. And the ground clearance of the bike is 145mm, which is slightly low, but it is decent enough for rough roads and your usual city commute. Now, because it is a cafe racer styled bike, you have a single seat, which is not at all comfortable. And definitely you sit aggressively, so the comfort goes even more down. I mean, for me, it does. But if you are a cafe racer lover, you know your business. Now, the suspension are stiffly tuned, and I can tell you that because I have already ridden it. And you get a monoshock, which is 7-step adjustable by WP. The bike gets aluminium cast swing arms and this side hung single barrel exhaust, which has Husqvarna motorcycle badging on it. Now let's check out the sound of the Whitpillion 250. At the rear is 150x60 section MRF revs tire mounted on a 17-inch alloy wheel. Along with that, you get a 230mm disc brake with ABS assistance. So it is a dual channel ABS setup, as I already told you. At the tail end is this good grab handle, the LED tail light and the LED turn indicators. Now the number plate goes on the mud hugger, which is over here. Let's hop on to the saddle and check out the instrument cluster. The saddle is stiff, as I already told you, and the saddle height is 835mm. Now I am 5'9", I can get both of my feet on the ground, but that is fake because I am standing on off-road. If you are 5'5 above, you will be managing with a tiptoe, but it is a tall rider bike. Now let's check out the instrument cluster. Complementing the round headlight is a round instrument cluster, and this instrument cluster is completely digital. So you have the digital tachometer, digital speedometer, gear position indicator, and this is a multi-information display, like ABS failures or any other information like side stand is down is displayed over here, along with your average fuel efficiency. On the lower left side is the engine temperature gauge. On the lower right side is the fuel gauge. Along with that, there are multiple indicators on the top. So you have the turn indicator, इंजन मैलफंक्शन इंडिकेटर, न्यूट्रल इंडिकेटर, हाई बीम इंडिकेटर, एबीएस इंडिकेटर, इमोबिलाइजर इंडिकेटर. सो ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड यू हैव द किल स्विच एंड द सेल्फ स्टार्ट स्विच विच इज अ सिंगल टच सेल्फ स्टार्ट. ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज द पास स्विच, द हेडलाइट कंट्रोल, द टर्न इंडिकेटर कंट्रोल एंड द हॉर्न. सो इट इज अ सिंगल टोन वेरी लाउड हॉर्न. नाउ दिस इज द क्लिप ऑन हैंडल बार एंड आई जस्ट लव दीज मिरर्स. नाउ लेट्स टेक इट ऑन अ राइड. बट बिफोर यू गो ऑन अ राइड, डोंट फॉरगेट टू वेयर योर हेलमेट एंड फॉलो ऑल रोड सेफ्टी रूल्स. Nowadays nothing really excites me. Only one of me and nobody like me. Phone ringing and I tell him it's ice. I got wifey on bling and she ice. Freeze, photo, please, no photos. No, jeez, no, please, no photos. Swedish have made this motorcycle design minimalistic, just like the SWAT Pillion, which makes it unique in looks as well as helps keep the weight of the bike low as compared to the other bikes in the segment. As it is a cafe racer styled bike, well, it is opposite of comfort. You can call it aggressive. It gets low set clip-on handlebars, rear set foot pegs, and a very commanding and aggressive seating stance, just like you would want in a cafe racer. For me, as I am not used to this, it slightly increases the stress on palms and shoulders, but for cafe racer lovers, this is heaven. And with stickier MRF revs, it is fun to take into the corners. The best thing about both the Huskies are the good round rear view mirrors, which complement the design as well as are very usable. On rainy days, I might make it rain today. I got paid off pain today. Thought it'd take the pain away. The fun really starts with its rev. The motor feels more powerful and punchy than the Duke 250. The one reason I can think to justify this is that the weight of this bike is lower, hence giving it a better power to weight ratio. The engine is very smooth. It feels like I'm riding the Duke 250 with a new attire and a very sporty stance. The vibrations are very well contained. You might feel them near the red line, but as I always say, it is more of a character and makes you push even harder. In the initial rev range, the power delivery is linear. Then it comes into the mid rev range where the punch really kicks in. And then it revs quickly to the red line and into the next gear. I like this quick pick because when you are into the corner, it is good and the experience remains the same when you are pulling it out. The engine delivers very well. At no point in time does it feel that it needs more power. I just like the refinement and the good punch, ensuring that you can have real fun in the corners or maybe the ghats. The 250s are my new favorite because of the balance they create between power and efficiency. If you're down in my management, I'm just warming up a way to lie. Old producers are the numbers one. Different colors in my baggy light. The other most important thing for a cafe racer is the gearbox, which should be quick, aggressive and precise. And I'm happy to announce this 6-speed unit checks all the right boxes. You can hear a click and the gear is engaged. Helping in this seamless transition is the slipper clutch, making the clutch efforts less and shifting smooth, leaving no chance of complaint. And don't even get me started on the brakes. The 320mm rotor in the front is enough for a 390. So guess how good is it for the Witpillion 250? Well, I'll answer it for you. The brakes are very precise and have a good bite. And as it is a dual channel ABS, there are no chances of wheel locking and skidding. Both the brakes offer a good amount of feedback, which makes it easier to calculate the braking distance required and helps you come to a halt even from high speeds. Monkey ribs are touching, need some food. Now you're all on live acting surprised, but you was fooled. I will be blunt and say that the suspensions are stiff, offering a good feedback so that you can feel the tarmac, and that is what happens when you jump through a bump. You can feel it good. Leaving all that aside, I just love the way it handles. The suspensions, tire, seating posture, and the weight all add up to make this bike very agile and responsive. It easily goes into the corners and is very easy to maneuver. In other words, it is really good at dodging. So my advice would be, dodge the potholes and make a new way for yourself, like this motorcycle made with a new design language. The design is absolutely unique and I like the way it looks. The minimalistic thing is great, but I feel Husqvarna should do something about the exposed wires. Apart from that, it feels so premium. In fact, the build quality is also great. I just love how both the Huskies are similar in looks, yet so different. They have shown us that by changing few elements, you can change the character. Our ride with the Whitpillion 250 has come to an end, and all I can say, it is one hell of a bike. It is a performance-packed bike. It is a performance-packed cafe racer like you want. And you can own it too at just Rs. 1.84 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi. So if you did like our video, do give it a thumbs up. And if you are new to our channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell so you never miss an update from Rev Explorers. You can also go ahead and check out our Instagram, Facebook and Twitter pages. We would love to have a chat with you. If you still have any doubts or any queries, leave it in the comment section below and we'll respond to you as soon as possible. In the end, it's time to say goodbye. We'll see you again in the next video. Till that time, stay home and stay safe. Bye-bye.